मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. माय नेम इज प्रोफेसर प्रियंका गौरखेड़े फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट. माय टुडेज टॉपिक इज हायर एजुकेशन इन इंडिया चैलेंजेस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉलोड कंटेंट दैट आई इन्वॉल्व द इंट्रोडक्शन व्हाट इज द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन इंडिया प्रेजेंट स्टेटस ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन इंडिया द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन इंडिया then aims of university education, then research funding agencies in India, then followed with the national fellowship and scholarship in India, and followed with the problems with higher education in India. What are the challenges with higher education in India? Opportunities. So let's start. In the Bill Legislative Council debate on 27 July, Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar said that the university is the machinery whereby educational facilities are provided to all those who are intellectually capable of using those facilities based on their advantage. If the university has to function properly, it is necessary that it should be controlled by what are called as educated classes. Therefore, higher education has been rightly defined as the mother of all the professions. As also mentioned in UNESCO, education should provide the skill for learning to know, learning to live together, learning to do, and learning to be. That means at the stage of life, every stage of life, we humans are ready to learn everything. Education system in India. The system of education in India evolved from the early Veda system. Nalanda, Vikramshila, and Takshashila were established in 4th and 5th century. The first institution to be given the status of university was established near to Calcutta in 1829. The first three universities established in India in 1850. That is the University of Bombay, University of Madras, and University of Calcutta. So Allahabad University was the latest formation. Then a present status of universities education system in India is the first university education in first is introduced by the British in the year 1857 when universities of Calcutta, Bombay and Madras were established. Lord Macaulay and Sir Charles Wood were the early pioneers of the modern education system in our country. At the time of independence, we had only 20 universities. You can't believe that we have only 20 universities and 695 colleges. But today we have 785 universities where colleges are increased to more than 39,000, putting the huge pressure on the university administration. Out of our total colleges, 37% colleges belong to arts, humanities, commerce and management. 16% colleges are belong to engineering, technology. 4% colleges are belong to medical. 2% colleges are belong to law. 0.5% colleges belong to agriculture. 0.1% belongs to veterinary and other point and 0.1%. Number of graduates coming out from the technical colleges was slightly over than 7 lakhs. However, 75% of technical graduates and more than 85% are general graduates. So in our India, the major wealth is our youth. That means from the age category of 18 to 40 years. So Indian higher education system is one of the largest education system in the world. I'll tell you the institutional framework of Indian higher education system. So we always spoke about the I am learning from Open University. I'm learning from the Open University. So what does it mean? So first we will discuss about what is Central University. So Central University is India is established by the Government of India by the Act of Parliament. What is State University? State University is established by the state government followed by the state legislative. Now, what is deemed university? We always spoke that I am learning from the autonomous institute. So what is deemed university? The institution which have been accorded to the status of university, which have been accorded the status of an university with the authority to award the own degrees through the central government notification. Means the institution itself the authority to award their degree to their students by the notification of central government. Now this open university provides the distance mode learning to the everyone. So an open university can be central or can be state university, imparting the education excluding through the distance mode at any branch. So institutes and national importance. Some of higher education institutes are awarded by the state of institute by the national importance of the act of parliament, and other institutes is provided the degree provided the degree through the university, both government aided on non-aided. So the institution imparting higher education level are regulated by the following bodies. This body is called as University Grant Commission. This body is responsible for the coordination, determination, and maintain the standard of the it should release the fund to universities and research organizations. So we know the Indian higher education system is a huge higher education system in the world. So followed by the University Grant Commission, that is UGC, we will run our system. So what is the aims of our university education? That is first and most important aim of our university education system, to pursue the knowledge to self and to the society, in the mind, and promoting creativity among the people. This is the most important aim of the university education, improving the efficiency and productivity in the social productive system. Empowering people is most important aim of the university education, and providing means for upward and social mobility. So now we will move toward the how our university functions. So which is shown in the screen. Just see, the university provided the base to the two system, that is first for researchers and other education system. So researchers, if university provide the funds and university provided the base to the researchers, what is come from the researchers, from researchers we got the research development and performance assessment, and we got as a output as a quality of researchers. Then from the education, we get the academic development and academic assessment, and from that we get the graduates with a desirable quality. So university is the base of our base for our researchers and for our education system. So you all know that in computer system there is a input, processor, or there is a output. So input, process, and output. Likewise, our university gets the input as a raw material from the researchers and from the students, or we can say that from the students or from the education system, we get as a input the university. University does the process on that too, and the output comes from the researchers. Output from the researchers is research. And from the students is a graduate desirable student. So we put as a output to the society. So input is a researchers and the education system. So university process it, and output is indirectly fed to our society. So yes, some of are known about the research funding agencies. Some of you are known about the research funding agencies in India. Some of you are not aware about it. there are some research funding agency in technical in technical system technical education system I'll cover here, but there are many more in medical, agriculture. There are different research funding agency. I am covering here technical education system. Research funding agency in India in technical education systems are the first and most important body is University Grant Commission, that is UGC. Then next is another important Indian Council of Social Science Research, ICSSR. Then National Council for Educational Research and Training. Then All India Council for Technical Education, that is AICTE. Then Department of Science and ESC. Then Council of Scientific and Industry Research, CSIR. Then Defense Research and Development Organization, that is DRDO, we all are known about it. Aeronautics Research and Development Board, Department of Atomic Energy, that is DAE. Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO. Then Department of Space, Ministry of Communication and Information Technology, followed with the Aeronautics Development Board, then Department of Coal, then Council of Medical Research, then Ministry of Communication and Information Technology, and Ministry of Environment and Forest. All are be very very confused about. We will go to the higher education, then we will get the scholarship. Not yes, there is a scholarship, or there is a for women as well as the for ST category students. So there are some funding agency or funding policies for the higher education system in India for women. So first is University Grant Commission, that is UGC. So they award the postdoctoral fellowship to the woman candidate. Eligibility for that, the candidate must have doctorate degree in relevant subject, preferably with published research work to their credit. In case of general or open category, 55% marks at UG level and 60% mark at PG level is compulsory. For reserve category, SC, ST, OBC candidates, 50% at UG level, 55% PG level. They award the fellowship ₹38,000 per month up to ₹46,500 after 2 years. Contingency is 50,000 per annum for 5 years. Again, there is another board, that is Science and Engineering Research Board, SERB. Eligibility for that, women scientists below 40 years of age who have received the degree, who have received the recognition from anyone from the following national academy. So that academies are Indian National Science Academy, New Delhi, Indian Academy of Science, Bangalore, in National Academy of Science, Allahabad, Indian National Academy of Engineering, New Delhi, National Academy of Medical Science, New Delhi, National Academy of Agriculture Science, New Delhi. From the following National Academy, the women have the recognition, then that women have the fellowship, like these women researchers will be supported with a research grant of 5,000 lakhs per annum. If the women having the recognition from the above list, then that women can get, women researchers can get the grant of 5 per annum for the period of 3 years. Yes, Indian Education System Foundation is first, there is a curriculum and pedagogy. Second most important pillar of the Indian higher education system is faculty. Third most important pillar of the Indian higher education system is research. Then fourth, partnership. Fifth, infrastructure. Sixth, funding. And seventh, governance. If good, if there is a good governance, then Indian higher education system must be updated. So yes, there is a fellowship and scholarship for a higher education system in for students. So eligibility of that, students seeking to pursue undergraduate, postgraduate, PhD, MPhil program. Then fellowship award varies from 25,000 per month to 28,000 per month. The scholarship covers the tuition fee and students up to maximum filling 2.5 lakhs per annum. It comes for professional and technical courses. Eligibility for minority students pursuing professional or technical courses 20,000 per annum, or actual maintenance allowance up to 1 lakh, 1,000 per month will get for the minority student. So yes, governance plays focus on institutional development with the three aspects, that is quality initiative, quality sustain, quality enhancement. Especially good governance in higher education system may be equated with the quality. That means quest of upgradation of curriculum, active support of leading leadership and governance, infrastructure, teaching learning evaluation, and yield for research and extension. So now moving towards, so and most important problem, there is a gap between supply and demand. So what is the, to fulfill this gap, we need to include what is the higher education. So so this is important problem with the higher education system. Another the higher education system in India is no project based learning. We are only focusing on theory knowledge. We are already already on the stage that we need to enhance yourself, or we need to acquire more knowledge in more knowledge practically. So we need to focus on project based learning. So this is the problem with higher education system. Then next problem is mushrooming of low quality institute. So in India there are many more institutes which is having a low quality. That means it's problem with the faculties, problem with the teaching learning process. So this should be avoided in our country at least, so that we groom ourselves. And another and most important problem with higher education system is we are only focusing that we are only going to get the job. We only want a job in the industry. So after the graduation, we only need the job. So all are thinking that if I get the job, then I my life is secured. But no one is thinking about the higher education and their personal development. So this is the most important and big problem with the higher education system. So challenges in Indian higher education system. So the big issue in India, there are many more challenges in Indian higher education system. First is quota system. Okay, so involving quota system at every stage or every field, which will obviously getting the poor and poor quality of students. So quota system is a big challenge in Indian higher education system. Then political influence again in the higher education system or education system will affect the education system. Then moral issues. Then what is mean by moral issues? Someone of you are always thinking that I am not ready to pursue any course after my graduation. I am not able to do this. I am not able to do that. So there must be some moral issues. And privatization is a big issue. Then financing for the institute is a big challenge with the higher education system. Teaching quality, day by day the teaching quality gets worse and worse. So teaching quality is must be the challenges with the Indian higher education system. Then accreditation. Some of the institutes from India still is not accredited. So this is a big challenge with the Indian higher education system. And research and innovation. So research and innovation means from among us, there are no one ready to do research, or no one is ready to do the project-based learning. No one is ready to do then that will be what our youth will do. So research is the area which we need to focus so that our system or our education system grow up. So this is the big challenge. Higher education system. So what are the opportunities in Indian higher education system? So first is the to increase the quantity of university. Till date there are universities, but if we increase the universities, then it good for ourselves. So then high-tech library research environment. So if we provide the good libraries with a all functionality, so our researcher can do better and better. So we have to put focus on the libraries and research field. We need to focus on financing. That means scholarships and fellowships. We need to focus on that, and this must be the opportunity in higher education system. In high quality faculties, the faculties with the PhDs, the faculties who are interested in the education field. So we put the focus on that. So this is must be the area of opportunity in Indian higher education system. So yes. So what is the conclusion for that? So it will be a tough road ahead academically and institutionally. India has moved beyond the traditional reacting, and leaders are no longer discomfort by risky and experimentation. So by 2030, India will have a largest population in the world in higher education age bracket. Increased urbanization and become level will drive demand for higher education. India's economy is expected to grow at fast pace, rapid industrialization, gross incremental workforce about 250 million by 2030. India could potentially emerge as a global supplier for skilled manpower given expected socio-economic scenario in 2030. India will need to a robust higher education system that can deliver on multiple priorities. So thank you.